So far, we have learned how a Raman instrument works. Today, we'll dive a little deeper into the technique and see how a Raman spectrum is generated.
The spectrograph delivers photons to specific angles according to their wavelengths, and so they end at different locations on the CCD chip. Here, the CCD captures a photo, and we can learn many things from it. Of course, it can tell us the photon's wavelength, but we can also count the number of photons. The more photons reach the CCD, the higher the light intensity, and eventually, the brighter the spot. Now, we have the Raman scattering intensity as a function of wavelength. However, in Raman spectroscopy, we make it a bit more complex, as we do not use wavelength as our x-axis. Instead, we use inverse centimeter, which is also called wave number. Basically, this is a very simple Raman spectrum. But why we are using wave numbers? Because unlike the wavelength, the wave number is directly proportional to the energy of the photon. By defining the laser wavelength as zero wave number in the Raman spectrum, we make our life much easier. Now, the relative wave number of Raman scattering is proportional to the energy between the vibrational states. This way, the laser wavelength does not play a role in the result anymore. This also means that you can use any laser wavelength for the Raman analysis. We will always have the same Raman shift for the same vibrational frequency. Next time, we will take a quick look at Raman's sister technique, infrared absorption.